often people will say, well, Abraham, why are we set up this way? In other words, why does it have to be hard if we are pure positive energy and then we are born into these bodies? Why are we so assured that there will be resistance surrounding us? Why does there have to be so much that we worry about that gets our attention and that sets up resistance within us and keeps us from being in the place of allowing that we so much want? And we say, it is because the benefit of the contrasting environment is millions of times more valuable than the negative is detrimental. In other words, if you did not have the ability to discern difference, you could not prefer. And if you could not prefer, you could not vibrationally summon source. And if you could not vibrationally summon source, then we would all cease to be. And so the entire universe is based upon our ability to conclude the new idea, which is the summoning forth of the new life into the new space. And then you say, but wouldn't it have been better if we could have had an environment where it was easier to stay connected? And we say, there is no environment that is easier to be connected than an environment in which you are free to choose thought. And you say, but it's hard to choose a thought that feels good when there's so much around me that feels bad. And we say, only because you haven't practiced it that way. Only because you've been convinced that you've got to clamor around the problem in order to find the solution. And there is truth in some of that. The clamoring around the problem is what is giving birth to the desire, you see. And so it's all an integral part of all of this. There are some who say that we should not encourage you to have desire. And yet we cannot stop you from having desire. The universe is established to produce desire. There are some who say it is inappropriate to have desire. And we say those are only those who have not figured out how to find vibrational alignment with the desire. So the desire is always painful. We understand why you would not want to have a desire that is painful, but the only reason it is painful is because you have not yet learned how to allow. So then you say, well, how do we allow? And we say, you find a thought that feels good and practice it until it becomes your proclivity. And you say, oh, that's far too simple. There's got to be something bigger than that. There's got to be something a lot more than just feeling good. And we say, there is nothing more important than that you feel good. Because when you feel good, you've got control of your vibration. And when you've got control of your vibration, you are the deliberate creator of your experience. So when you say, why do we have to allow? We say, it is because you were born into an environment where there are choices. You were born into an environment where there is variety. In other words, if you lived in a household where everybody thought exactly the same way, and nobody had any contention about anything, everybody wanted everything exactly the same. You were all born to love pizza, and you were all born to love milk, and you were all born to love the color yellow, and you were all born to love hardwood floors instead of carpeted floors, and you were, in other words, if you were all born with these samenesses, you say, oh, we would get along so famously. We all sing the same songs and we do the same things, and we say you would not be stimulated to a new idea, and a continuing life force could not continue to be drawn within you, because you need, we all need an active calling. That's big. We all need an active calling. There has to be an activation of that summoning of energy. And as long as there is an activation of that summoning of energy, then life continues, and it is our promise to you that life will always continue. And so you say, well, this activation of this energy is a good thing, but my resistance to it is not a good thing. Why do I have to learn allowing? And we say, you would not have to learn allowing if you had not learned disallowing. And you say, that's my point exactly. Why was I born into an environment where I learned disallowing? Why do I have to go back now and learn how to allow? Shouldn't I just naturally allow? And we say, because you wanted the environment of difference, and you needed to find your bearing, and you needed to find your place, and you needed to decide what you want. In other words, we promised you, you did not want to come into an environment where you just said yes, 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 yes to all of it. You wanted to say yes, no, well, maybe. Well, what do I think? What do I conclude? What is my preference? Otherwise, your perspective has no value if you are not here to decide, to discern, to prefer something new, you see. So then you say, but I thought we are all one. And we say, we are all one, playing off one another for the purpose of coming up with a new idea. And you say, well, it's painful because now I have to learn how to allow all over again. And we say, you'll be all right. you can use your guidance system to know. If you don't get too far from where you are, it's always easy to bring yourself back to center. And even if you do get far from where you are, it's still easy to bring yourself back to center. It just takes deciding that feeling good is worth something. And practicing with real determination to feel good for no other reason than to feel good. And in time you show yourself that allowing is not a big issue. It's easy to allow. In fact, it is your dominant proclivity. You would much rather love than not love. You know how we know that? When you don't love, you feel miserable. You would much rather praise than criticize. You know how we know that? Because when you criticize, you feel awful, and when you praise, you feel wonderful. You would much rather know your success and know your value than to feel that you do not have value. You know how we know? Because we feel your pain when you choose the other. In other words, we think that it must be so easy to know the stove is hot. In other words, that does not feel good. It does not feel good to put your hand on a hot stove. And we do not understand sometimes why it is so hard to take your hand off the stove. And you say, my mother had her hand on the stove, her mother had her hand on the stove. Our family puts its hand on the stove. It's just what we all do. The day I was born, they put my hand on the stove. And we say, but now you get to decide how you like it. And you say, but it's hard. Do I dare take my hand from the stove? And we say, risk it and try it. And you say, ah, it is sweet relief when I take my hand from the stove. But look, my mother still has her hand on the stove, and my government still has its hand on the stove. They've all got their hand on the stove. Who am I to find the relief of not putting my hand on the stove? And we say, all right, put your hand back on the stove if you want to, but understand that you get to allow or not allow. These are your choices. We're wanting you to understand that it's not hard to allow. In fact, the hardest thing of all is to learn patterns of not allowing who you are. It's a lot harder to be confused than to be clear-minded. It's a lot harder to be sick than it is well. It's a lot harder to not have enough money than to have enough money. It's a lot harder to be negative than to be positive. It's a lot harder to be pessimistic than to be optimistic. The hard, 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 hard thing is not allowing. It's easy to allow. You just have to give yourself permission to do it and practice it a little bit. You are on your own in this, and you like it that way. You came into this environment knowing that you would be an individual consciousness that would have your individual preferences, and that anything that you in your powerful individualness identify as your desire source energy will answer. It is our expectation that you will prove to yourself that you have the ability to let it in. It is so much easier than you think. There's just one thing that you have to remember. It is good to feel good. It is good to feel good. Clarity is your natural state of being. Healthy is your natural state of being. Eager is your natural state of being. Loving is your natural state of being. It is natural for you to have desire, and it is natural for you to anticipate happy outcomes. And it is natural for you to love, and it is natural for you to sing, and it is natural for you to play. It is natural for you to skip. It is natural for you to be joyful. It is natural for you to know well-being. It is natural for you to expand. It is natural for you to question. It is natural for you to find interest. It is natural for you to want more. And it is natural for you to feel good. And anything else is resisting the natural state of who you are. There is great love here for you. We are complete.